Hey everybody, welcome to a very special Sunday edition of my Facebook live stream show. Today is a salute to classic television. So without further ado, I want to start singing some of these great songs I have set up for you today. Glad you're here.
It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. A beautiful day to be neighbors, so won't you be mine? Would you be mine? It's a neighborly day in the beauty wood. A neighborly day to be beauties, so won't you be mine? Could you be mine? Hey, I have always wanted to have a neighbor just like you. I've always wanted to live in a neighborhood with you.
That would be scary.
Let's make the most of this beautiful day. And since we're together, I might as well say, would you be mine? Won't you be mine? Won't you be my neighbor? Oh, won't you please? Please, won't you be my neighbor?
Hello, neighbors. Can you say Sunday fun day? I knew you could. Hope everybody had a great week. I missed you. I was looking forward to this show, as I do every week. But in particular, I was looking forward to this one because these show tunes, TV show theme songs, are so much fun to sing. And many of them you will know. I might have a couple of curveballs to throw at you. But I'm looking forward to sharing this afternoon with you for the next hour in a little bit. So let's sing something that brings me back to my childhood. I had to have my underoos on. Remember these? So I had Superman and Batman underoos. And I had them on and my snack ready to eat because after the show it was right to bed.
It's time to play the music. It's time to light the lights. It's time to meet the Muppets on the Muppet Show tonight. It's time to put on makeup. It's time to dress up right. It's time to raise the curtain on the Muppet Show tonight. Why do we always come here? I guess we'll never know. It's like a kind of torture to have to watch the show. Now let's get things started. Why don't we get things started on the most sensational, inspirational, celebrational, computational? This is what we call the Muppet Show.
Gonzo would try to hit a note on a horn or something like that. Good old Gonzo. With that schnoz of his and his affection for chickens. Actually, I know a lot of men here in Palm Springs who have an affection for chicken. Let me wet my whistle and say hi to my friends out here. I decided, considering the material today, I had to put something on reflective of one of the shows. You know, I had these grandiose plans to change outfits, and I'm like, Ron, just put on one little thing and call it a day. Let's not get carried away. Let's see. Oh, we have a lot of the usual suspects out there. Nice to see everybody. There's Mark Kays, a.k.a. Dr. Phil. You will always be Dr. Phil to me. And lovely Chris, his other half. Hey, Jen. Oh, hello, Michael. My brother's here. Yay! Henry in D.C. and my sister's on board. Thanks, guys, for tuning in. We wouldn't be able to do any kind of tribute to TV without at least two or three theme songs from animated shows. This one goes way back. You know, a lot of these shows were premiered before, either before I was born or before I was old enough to really enjoy them. But not all that I did, that I'm doing today, will be stuff that was super early. But, of course, a lot of these cartoons and a lot of these other shows are aired over and over with reruns, especially with the streaming services like Hulu, Prime, and all that stuff. Anyway, do you remember this one? Woody Woodpecker. And a lot of these songs had words that they didn't sing necessarily when they ran the song for the show. This one goes like this.
Ah, 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 it's the Woody Woodpecker song. Da, 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 da. few holes in a tree to see if a redwood is really red. Nothing to him on the tiniest whim to peck a few holes in your head. Da 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 da, it's the woodpecker tune. He's making all the woodpeckers swoon. He doesn't make sense to the dumb and the tense. All the lady woodpeckers along.
And those early days, they used a big band for a lot of that stuff. This one in particular used a big band, and it's one of the most famous animated television show songs of all, I think.
Flintstones, beat the Flintstones, they're a page right out of history. From the town of Bedrock, they're a modern Stone Age family. Ride with the family down the street to the courtesy and friends to feet. When you're with the Flintstones, have a yabba dabba do time. A dabba do time, we'll have a day on time.
Just last week, we pulled up the movie made in the 90s, The Flintstones, and it was so good. If you haven't seen it, find it and watch it. It's hilarious. The effects are great. It's got some big stars. Rosie O'Donnell plays Betty. John Goodman is Fred. Rick Moranis plays Barney. I mean, it's really excellent. Fast forward to a little bit more of a modern animated TV show. This is probably one of my ultimate favorites. I used to fall asleep late into the night or early morning in my cabin on Carnival Cruise Lines after work watching episodes of this that I kept on my laptop.
That all you see is violence and movies and sex on TV. But where are those good old-fashioned values on which we used to rely? Well, lucky there's a Family Guy. Lucky there's a man who positively can do all the things that make us laugh and cry. He's a Family Guy.
He is so irreverent. Seth MacFarlane is the creator of Family Guy and a voice of several of the characters, including the protagonist, Peter Griffin. It's a great show. And he references, he pulls material from everything. And he's one of those no-holds-barred, everybody-is-allowed-to-be-offended kind of writers. Pulling back now a few years, you'll remember this one.
Listen to a story about a man named Jed, a poor mountaineer who barely kept his family fed. Then one day he was shooting at some food, and up through the ground came a bubbling crude. Oil, that is, black gold, Texas tea. The first thing you know, Jed's a millionaire. The kinfolk said, Jed, move away from there. California is the place you ought to be. They loaded up the truck and they moved to Beverly Hills, that is, swimming pools, movie stars. Now it's time to say goodbye to Jed and all his kin. They would like to thank you for kindly dropping in. You're invited back next week to see this locality. My partial was coming out. To have a heaping helping them with their hospitality. Hillbilly, that is, set a spell, take your shoes off.
Then, of course, you get the pick. You know, I haven't seen a lot of the Beverly Hillbillies. I've seen snippets over the, you know, over the years, but not one I'm super familiar with. Yes, Sean, you actually took the phrase that I was trying to find, and that is, going back to Family Guy, Seth MacFarlane is an equal opportunity offender. That's right. But he's a very smart guy, well, and his writers as well. I mean, they pull material from history, from art, from music, from pop culture, you name it, politics. In the same vein, here's one you all recognize.
Acres is the place to be. Farm living is a life for me. Land spreading out so far and wide. Keep Manhattan, give me that countryside. Oh, New York is where I'd rather stay. I got the allergic smelling hair. I just adore a penthouse view. Darling, I love you, but give me Park Avenue. The chores, the stores, fresh air, Times Square, you are my wife. Goodbye, city life, Green Acres, we are there.
What was her name? One of the Gabors, right? Oh, man. You can have some of these newer shows. Especially some of the comedies are not very good, in my opinion. You know me, I'm old-fashioned. Now, I'm trying to learn a lot of these buttons on this computerized piano of mine so I can kind of change the sound on some of these songs. So let's see what I put in here for my notes. This one should be these two buttons. That's it. I teased this one yesterday on a little mini video, so you guys know the words to all of these, so sing along. I can't hear you, but I can imagine that I can, all right? Yes!
The creepy and the kooky, mysterious and spooky, and altogether ooky, the Addams Family. Their house is a museum where people come to see them. They really are a screen of the Addams Family. Neat. Sweet. Petite. So get a witch's all on. Broomstick you can call on. We're gonna play a call on the Addams Family.
Oh. Some of these songs. The Munsters is also good. I'm not including that one in today's show because I don't think that one has words, but they had some great instrumentation on those shows. Am I coming through okay out there? Was it Zsa Zsa? It was Zsa Zsa, wasn't it? One of the Gabors. I'm going to check my computer, make sure the numbers are okay here. Okay, very good. I'm always panicked something's going to happen with this. We're hardwired to the modem today, so cross your fingers that the technology gods will stay with me. I'm going to skip ahead to a few that we will recognize from the 80s. This one was, I think it started in 78 and went into the 80s, so it sort of bridges the 70s and 80s television programs. Alan Thicke, remember him? He wrote this theme song and several more from other shows. I'm going to change the key so I can hit the notes.
Now the world don't move to the beat of just one drum. What might be right for you may not be right for some. And a man is born, he's a man of means. But along came two, they got nothing but the genes. But they got different strokes it takes, different strokes it takes, different strokes to move the world. Everybody's got a special kind of story. Everybody find a way to shine. No matter what you got, not a lot. So what? You'll have yours, you'll have theirs, and I'll have mine. And together we'll be fine. Different strokes to move the world. Yes, it does. It takes different strokes to move the world.
That was a great show. What you talking about, Willis? In the same vein, and also the same composer, is another Alan Thicke cover of a show. Yeah, what you talking about, Willis? Is this one.
Well, you take the good, you take the bad, you take them both, and there you have the facts of life. The facts of life. There's a time you gotta go and show you're growing up and know about the facts of life. The facts of life. When the world never seems to be living up in your dreams, and suddenly you're finding out the facts of life are all about you. Ooh. It takes a lot to get there right. Learning the facts of life. Learning the facts of life. Learning the facts of life. Learning the facts of life.
Actually, that was a spinoff of Different Strokes, because Mrs. Garrett was the housekeeper in Different Strokes, and then, of course, she becomes a house marm. Is marm the word I'm looking for here? In the, you know, the girls' school, whatever.
Girls! Girls! But Mrs. Garrett!
It got kind of serious as I got older. That was, you know, Tootie was drinking, I think, and God knows. Anyway. staying with the 80s, of course, this is probably one of the most well-known of the 80s theme songs. It's Cheers.
Making your way in the world today takes everything you got. Taking a break from all your worries sure would help a lot. Now, wouldn't you like to get away? Sometimes you wanna go where everybody knows your name, and they're always glad you came. You wanna go where you can know people are all the same. You wanna go where everybody knows your name. Cheers is filmed in front of a live studio audience.
There's actually more verses to that song, which was written by a guy named Gary Portnoy, with help from Judy Hart Angelo. And if you go to iTunes, you can search for, what would you call them, failed attempts when he was writing a theme song for the show. They were rejected songs. And you can hear, like, with each progressive attempt, it was getting closer to this kind of a feel. And I actually have an original opening verse here that was left on the scrap on the floor, the cutting room floor. The original opening verse goes like this.
Sing the blues when the Red Sox lose. It's a crisis in your life. On the run because all your girlfriends want to be your wife. And the laundry ticket is in the wash.
Yeah, not very good. Hold on, I'm screwing this up over here. Deep, 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 deep. I want a different sound on this piano there. The other verses he wrote that make the song complete, if you heard them all, go like this.
All those nights and you've got no lights, the check is in the mail, and your little angel hung the cat up by its tail. And your third fiancé didn't show. Sometimes you wanna go where everybody knows your name, and they're always glad you came. You wanna be where you can see troubles are all the same. You wanna go where everybody knows your name.
Third verse.
Climbing the walls when no one calls, you've lost that love again. And the more you're down and out, the more you need a friend. When you long to hear a kind hello, sometimes you wanna go where everybody knows your name, and they're always glad you came. You wanna be where you can see are all the same. You wanna go where everybody knows your name.
I won't bore you with the fourth verse, but you get the idea that that he wrote a lot of stuff for that particular song. Now, I'd like to pause for a moment with a word from our sponsors.
Extra value is what you get when you buy Coronet. Coronet paper towels are soft, strong, and absorbent, and they give you 125 sheets. That's more than any other national brand. Coronet bath tissue is soft two-ply tissue in pretty designer prints. And soft, pure white Coronet facial tissue costs less than any other national brand. So buy Coronet paper products from George Pacific. Extra value is what you get when you buy Coronet.
again, Carl.
Same here. How about dinner sometime real soon?
How about right now? I'm starved.
Hey, you're on. I'll pick you right up.
Hey, how would you like to have a phone like that?
Great, then I can see you all the time. Hey, why the quick cigarette?
Oh, I don't know. Sometimes they just don't taste so good.
Here, have a Viceroy.
Don't settle for summer of a taste, summer of a time. Viceroy gives you all the taste, all the time.
Are these Viceroys always this good?
All the time.
Don't settle for summer of a taste, summer of a time. Viceroy gives you all the taste, all the time. All the taste, all the time.
Viceroy, king size or extra longs.
All the taste, all the time.
Mr. Turtle, how many licks does it take to get to the Tootsie Roll Center of a Tootsie Pop?
I never made it without biting. Ask Mr. Owl.
Mr. Owl, how many licks does it take to get to the Tootsie Roll Center of a Tootsie Pop?
Let's find out. One, two, three. Three.
How many licks does it take to get to the Tootsie Roll Center of a Tootsie Pop? The world may never know.
Light, the toy that lets you create beautiful pictures with light.
Light.
Work with colorful pegs that glow with light. Light bulb not included. Make people, animals, things. And with refills, Bugs Bunny or Bozo the Clown. You can make lots of pretty pictures with Light Bright from Hasbro.
I can't believe I ate that whole thing.
You ate it, Ralph.
I can't believe I ate that whole thing.
No, Ralph, I ate it.
I can't believe I ate that whole thing.
Take two Alka-Seltzer.
Alka-Seltzer neutralizes all the acid your stomach has churned out. For your upset stomach and headache, take Alka-Seltzer and feel better fast.
Did you drink your Alka-Seltzer?
The whole thing.
I hope you like those. I spent a lot of time combing through dozens of commercials on YouTube, and you know, I had to narrow it down to just a few to show with you, to share with you today, and of course a lot that I wanted to show have been left out, but we might have a few more coming up in a little bit. Back to our program of theme songs from shows. I'm still in the 80s, and a composer who wrote several different TV theme show songs, his name is Mike Post. This particular song doesn't have any lyrics, but you will recognize it right away, I'm sure. Can you recognize that one? That is Hill Street Blues. Yeah, Linda got it. Great show. I ran for a number of years too, if I recall. Mike Post also wrote this particular song.
Look what's happening to me. Myself. Suddenly I am on top of the world. Should have been somebody else. Believe it or not, I'm walking on air. I never thought I could feel so free. Flying away on a wing and a prayer. Who could it be?
just like the light of a new day. It hit me from out of the blue. Bring me out of that spell I was in, making all of my wishes come true. Believe it or not, I'm walking on air. Never thought I could feel so free. Flying away on a wing and a prayer. Who could it be? Believe it or not, it's just me.
American Hero, believe it or not. I think that song, actually, they played it on the radio because it was just, had a great sort of pop song feel to it. I remember that coming on the radio. In the 80s still. I can play the notes. Linda.
Thank you for being a friend. Travel down the road. Back again. Heart is true and you're a pal and a confidant. Never you threw a party and you invited everyone you knew. And you would say the biggest gift would be for me. The card attached would say thank you for being a friend.
Still going strong with reruns, man. You see them everywhere. Just references to them. Clothing and products and shows, live shows, stuff online. Gotta love Bea Arthur. I'm a big fan of Bea Arthur for sure. Let me have a little water and stop for a moment, catch my breath, and say hi to everybody. Make sure my computer's still doing okay. Hanging on. Hey, the Easters are on board, too. Hey, everybody. Eric Post wants to hear Lionel Richie. Well, today's show is a television theme show. Television song, theme song, song, show, theme. I don't know if Lionel Richie wrote any TV shows, but I can sure save Lionel for next time. I love singing his songs. Speaking of next time, this coming Friday is my birthday, and so we're going to escape to the coast. We've been in this house and in this neighborhood for weeks and months, and I'm going out of my mind in this 110-degree temperature. So things are still open here and there, if you find the right city. So Saturday, Sunday, whatever, we're going to drive to San Diego, I think, and I just need to get my feet in the water and be in some regular temperatures. So I won't have a show next week, so I'll see you all in 2 weeks for the next show. Speaking of shows, this is like the show of shows, as far as I'm concerned, with television. Considered by many to be one of the greatest television programs ever made. And it's called All in the Family, written and produced, created by Norman Lear, who, as most of you will know, well, he's still alive. He's like 97 or something like that. He wrote a lot of big hit TV programs. That broke ground in many ways, with the technology they used, with the material that they covered and show plot lines, the characters, et cetera, et cetera. And you probably guessed it, this is All in the Family. So if you will be my Edith to my Archie, or my Archie to my, your my Archie to my Edith, we'll sing this together. I'm tongue-twisted today.
Way Glenn Miller played.
Sounds like ain't that parade.
Guys like me, we had it made. Now through the days.
And you knew where you wind up.
Goyles for Goyles and Lumberman. Mister, we could use a man like Herbert Hoover again. Didn't need no welfare state.
Everybody.
Yeah, that's so iconic, isn't it? That's why I chose to sit with Edith at the piano for the graphic I used for the promotion of my show today. I love that show so much, and it was so groundbreaking. I actually, if you'll allow me, I made a couple of notes I wanted to share with you about the show. It ran, it ran 9 seasons, and it opened in January of 71. And as I mentioned, it covered lots of topics never discussed before in TV programs, like sexism and religion, miscarriages, abortion, homosexuality, impotence. I don't remember an episode about that, but there must have been. The Vietnam War, of course, was very prevalent in that, with Meathead going at it with Archie. And it also had several spin-offs, including Maud would be Arthur. She played in 2 episodes in the All in the Family, one where she just played Edith's cousin, and then they liked it so much, they wrote a second episode for her to be sort of a star in, and that was sort of a backdoor pilot for what we now know as Maud, which was a spinoff. Then, of course, The Jeffersons, which had its own 1 or 2 spinoffs of its own, and this I didn't know, but there was another spinoff from All in the Family. Oh, well, there was Good Times as well, but there was one I had never heard of, and it was called, where did I put that? Right here, Gloria. Did you know this? They actually had a spinoff about Archie and Edith's daughter, Gloria. It was called Gloria. The third spinoff of All in the Family, focusing on the now-divorced Gloria, starring in a new life as an assistant trainee to some veterinarians. Premiered in 1982 and only ran for 1 season, so it didn't work out. But yeah, very influential program. Going back to Family Guy for a second, because there is an episode in Family Guy. No, I take that back. This was not Family Guy. This was The Simpsons. And they did an episode where they mocked or parodied the All in the Family opening theme. And instead of the original song, which was people living in the 70s singing about the 50s, The Simpsons did a version where they were in modern times singing about the 70s. So it goes like this.
Boy, the way the Bee Gees played, movies John Travolta made, guessing how much Elvis weighed. Those were the days, and you knew where you were then, watching shows like Gentle Ben.
Remember that?
Mr. We could use a man like Sheriff Lobo again. Disco Duck and Fleetwood Mac, blaring out of my 8-track. Michael Jackson still was black. Those were the days.
I thought at first it was Family Guy because it's that kind of humor, but no, it was The Simpsons who did that version. And then, of course, you have that iconic closing theme of All in the Family, which was a different theme than the opener. It was written by Roger Calloway. Remember this, with the credits were scrolling at the end. Roger Calloway didn't write lyrics to that when he wrote it for the closing theme, but Carol O'Connor, who starred as Archie in the show, asked Roger if he could write lyrics to it. And because actually Carol liked doing sort of cabaret-style shows, and if you look on YouTube, you can find a couple of them. And in one of them, he's tuxedo-clad on a stage, and he talks about this song and writing lyrics to it, and Roger Calloway himself comes out and plays a spinet piano right on the stage while Carol O'Connor sings the words. The song's called Remembering You. It goes like this.
Got a feeling it's all over now. It's all over now, we're through. And tomorrow I'll be lonesome, remembering you. Got a feeling the sun will be gone. The day will be long and blue. And tomorrow I'll be a faraway look in your eye when you try to pretend to be. Everything is the same that it used to be. I see that it's all over now. It's all over now, we're through. Tomorrow I'll be starting, remembering sad because we're part. Remembering calls to lick my heart, remembering you.
Roger Kellaway and Carol O'Connor on the lyrics. How about that? Okay, let's do one of the spin-offs from that show.
We're moving on up to the east side, to a deluxe apartment in the sky. Finally got a piece of pie.
Here we go.
Fish don't fry in the kitchen. Beans don't burn on the grill. Took a whole lot of trying just to get up that hill. Now we're up in the big leagues, getting our turn at bat. As long as we live, it's you and me, baby, and it ain't nothing wrong with that.
That's one, even if you don't like the show, man, you gotta love that song. And of course, this other spin-off with B. Arthur, if I can get the right chords here. And just a little bit of organ on this one, I think. Let's see.
Lady Godiva was a freedom rider. She didn't care for the whole world, but Joan of Arc with the Lord to guide her. She was a sister who really cooked. Isadora was the first bride burner, and you're glad she showed up.
Oh, yeah.
When the country was falling apart, Betsy Ross got it all set up. And then there's more. And then there's more. And enterprising anything but tranquilizing
round. Oh, yeah. God will get you for that, Walter. Oh, yeah. I got one more. Let's see. I got my keys on these things here.
Good times, anytime you meet a baby. Good times, anytime you meet a friend. Good times, anytime.
This one I didn't know. I had to learn this for this week. I knew of it, but I had never played it before. And when I was pulling up the words, I realized that they were written by Alan and Marilyn Bergman, who are world-renowned lyricists who have written scores and scores of famous songs with many, many famous composers. So I thought that was interesting. Not all theme songs have lyrics, as I mentioned earlier, but some of them have lyrics that were written for the song but were not included in the presentation of the song in the show. And I want to do a few of those for you right after these messages.
No little cinnamon gum freshens breath longer than Big Red.
So kiss a little longer, laugh a little longer, stay close a little longer, longer with Big Red. That Big Red freshness passed right through it. Fresh bread goes on and on. Why?
like to buy the world a home and furnish it with love. Grow apple trees and honeybees and snow white turtle doves. I'd like to teach the world to sing. Sing with me.
Does your tape collection look like this? Then you need a KTEL tape selector. With special attachments, it fits conveniently in your car, stores all your tapes neatly, ready for easy selection. Tilt the first tape forward. The others follow automatically. Take your selection when it appears. When replacing tapes, tape selector automatically finds the proper place. In your home or in your car, protect your valuable tapes with Tape Selector, $4.99 from KTEL.
Walks the stair without a care and shoots so high in the sky. Bounce up and down just like a clown. Everyone knows it's Slinky, the best present yet to give or get, but costs a little to buy. The hit of the day when you're ready to play. Everyone knows it's Slinky. It's Slinky, it's Slinky, for fun it's the best of the toys. It's Slinky, it's Slinky, the favorite of girls and boys. It's Slinky, it's Slinky, for fun it's the best of the toys. It's Slinky, it's Slinky, the favorite of girls and boys. Everyone wants a Slinky, you ought to get a Slinky.
I had a Slinky. Did you guys have Slinkies? I mean, talk about a brilliant invention. I mean, how much does it cost to make those damn things? Especially before they added the, you know, the animal heads and all that. Mine didn't last long. You know, I would try to drop them from the stairs over the edge of the balcony and they would stretch out. Then you're screwed. Once it gets stretched, forget it. We were talking about some theme songs that we are familiar with, but maybe not the lyrics that had been written for them. Here's one. Gotta go back to a piano sound. Once more. I Love Lucy, right? Music by Elliot Daniel, lyric by Harold Adamson, and the lyrics go like this.
I love Lucy and she loves me. We're as happy as two can be. Sometimes we quarrel, but then how we love making up again. Lucy kisses like no one can. She's my missus and I'm her man. And how life's heaven, you see. Cause I love Lucy, I love Lucy, and Lucy loves me.
Who knew? This one also had lyrics, remember this? Hogan's Heroes. And once I sing a couple of these lyrics for you, you'll know why they didn't sing them for this show.
Heroes, heroes, husky men of war, sons of all the heroes of the war before. We're all heroes up to our heroes. You ask the questions, we make suggestions. That's what we're heroes are for.
Second.
Good heroes love a good big fight. Open up them bomb bays, brighten up the night.
We applaud the people who laud us. You pull the roses, we punch the noses. What we're heroes for.
Terrible! But it's a great little theme. I know they do that in marching bands a lot. What was the name of the actor, the one who played Hogan? I know he had sort of a weird ending to his life. It's right on the tip of my tongue. And of course, Colonel Klink. Fantastic. There's a great interview on YouTube of the actor who played Colonel Klink. I think it was, I want to say he was not German, but I think he was Austrian or something. I'm not, don't quote me on that. But it was very interesting to learn about him and his remembrances of that show. Let's see. Oh, I got a kind of a neat thing here. This is another, pardon me while I'm playing around here. Another one that we know without lyrics, but they did write lyrics to this. Yes. I Dream of Jeannie, of course, another fun show with a young Larry Hagman. And the lyrics are actually kind of cute. They go like this.
Jeannie, fresh as a daisy, see how she just obeys me, does things that amaze me so. She smiles, presto, the rain goes. She blinks, up come the rainbows. Cars stop, even the train goes slow when she goes by. She paints the sunshine on every flower. Springtime, the air with laughter. Closes a quarter, actor three. There's no one like Jeannie. I'll introduce you to her, but it's no use to you, sir. Jeannie's in love with me.
Cute. How about this one? Christine Lyon, these tunes were sexist. Well, the lyrics were, that's for sure. But considering the times that they were written in, that was a thing. I was going to sing the words to Bewitched to you, which you may have not heard before.
Bewitched, bewitched, you've got me in your spell. A bewitched, a bewitched, you know your craft so well. Before I knew what you were doing, I looked into your eyes. That brand of woo that you were brewing took me by surprise. Are you witch? You witch? One thing is for sure, that stuff you pitch just hasn't got a cure. My heart was under lock and key, but somehow you got it unhitched. I never thought my heart would be had. Now I'm caught in, kind of glad you'd be bewitched.
Cute. Great characters. Yeah, Gladys Kravitz, the nosy neighbor. Abner! Abner! There's an elephant in the Stevens living room! I have a fan blowing on me and it went off. I think because I accidentally hit the timer. Let me put that back on. There we go. Especially wearing the long sleeves today. I need that air. Dr. Bombay. And who was the aunt who always screwed things up? Aunt Clara. Aunt Clara. And of course, Paul Lynde had a handful of appearances in that show. He was remarkable. Center Square, Hollywood Square for the longest time. Well, this is going to change the sound of what we've been doing ever so slightly. Never this one. From the Blues Brothers. When they got the gig at that really rough neck place, and they try to sing some blues, and the guests aren't into it, and they sing this song. Oh, God. A little bit of a different song now. Also one that was used in the show without the words. Actually, this comes from a movie. Made a show out of the movie, kept the song, although they changed it so it didn't sound quite so sad. And it's my favorite television program of all time, and it's MASH. Music by Johnny Mandel and Mike Altman. The lyrics are very sad. I'm not going to share those today. I want to keep it happy. But it's a great show. I think it won 11 seasons. Many, many, many awards. This one will go back in time again. I thought about doing things sort of in a chronological order, but there were other things I wanted to talk about with the shows, where some things from yesteryear were clumped better with things. In more recent times, so I didn't do that. So pardon me if we're kind of going back and forth on the timeline here. Oh yeah, baby.
This man who leads a life of danger. Everyone he meets, he stays a stranger. With every move he makes, another chance he takes. The odds are he won't live to see tomorrow. Secret agent man, secret agent man. They've given you a number and taken away.
Thank you.
sunshine on the Riviera one day. Then bleeding in an alley in Bombay the next day. Don't let the wrong word slip while kissing persuasive lips. Cause odds are you won't live to see tomorrow. It's a deadly game.
Yeah! That's a great theme. It's got, plus it stole this from the Bond theme. You can get away with little things like that without copying.
Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Shamil, Shamazel, shots and Fed from Corporated.
We're gonna do it. Give us any chance, we'll take it. Read us any rule, we'll break it. We're gonna make our dreams come true. Do it our way. Nothing's gonna turn us back now. Straight ahead and on the track now. We're gonna make those dreams come true. There's nothing we won't try. Never heard the word impossible this time. There's no stopping us. So we're gonna do it. On your mark, get set, and go now. We got a dream and we just know now. We're gonna make that dream come true. And we'll do it our way, and our way. Make all our dreams come true. We'll do it.
That was a spinoff of Happy Days, and I only remembered, I don't know why I didn't connect that sooner, I only remembered the Happy Days today, and I'm like, I'm not going to quickly throw that in. And if you remember, the earlier episodes used a different theme, right? They used Rock Around the Clock, and then they had the Happy Days theme after that. Geez, I only have a few more to go, but before I continue, here's a word for our sponsors.
How often does your job call you out of bed in the middle of the night? Well, if you were a doctor, it would be often. And generally, there isn't much time to spare.
Coffee, doctor?
Oh, fine. Have a Camel with your coffee.
Thanks.
You know, this night work's kind of rough, isn't it?
That's right. But a Camel's always a pleasure.
Yes, folks, the pleasing mildness of a Camel is just as enjoyable to a doctor as it is to you or me. In a nationwide survey, doctors in all branches of medicine were asked, "What cigarette do you smoke, doctor?" The brand named most was Camel's. Tens of thousands of doctors, general practitioners, surgeons, specialists, doctors in every branch of medicine were included. And according to this nationwide survey, more doctors smoke Camels than any other cigarette. Try Camels yourself. The cigarette so many doctors enjoy.
You've got the look, I want to know better. You've got the look that's all together. Working, playing, day or night. Joy Ash has the fit that's right. Jordash look. The Jordash look.
My baloney has a first name, it's O-S-C-A-R. My baloney has a second name, it's M-A-Y-E-R. Oh, I love to eat it every day. And if you ask me why, I'll say, 'cause Oscar Mayer has a way with B-O-L-O-G-N-A.
Oscar Mayer, the first name in Bologna.
How's that?
There's a fragrance that's here today, and they call it Charlie. A different fragrance that thinks your way, yeah, they call it Charlie. Kinda young, kinda now, Charlie. Kinda free, kinda wow, Charlie. Kinda fragrance that's gonna stay, and it's here now.
Charlie by Revlon, a most original fragrance.
I am stuck on Band-Aid, cause Band-Aid stuck on me. I am stuck on Band-Aid, cause Band-Aid stuck on me. Cause they really stick to your fingers and they stick on bended knees.
Remember, only Johnson & Johnson makes Band-Aid brand adhesive bandages with the unique Super Stick adhesive. Depend on the protection of America's number one bandage.
I am stuck on Band-Aid, cause Band-Aid stuck on me.
Oh, I had to include the Band-Aid one. And a lot of these, you know, the same jingle was used over the decades. They just kind of updated this instrumentation or whatever. Did you notice a couple of young stars in that last Band-Aid commercial? There was Terry Garr, who played the meter maid, the one with the Band-Aid on her foot. And at the end, there was John Travolta in the shower with a guy. No surprise. I'm kidding. And of course, the Band-Aid commercial and Oscar Mayer Wiener songs and many other hit commercial jingles are written by Barry Manilow. He wrote one for Dr. Pepper. I think one of his biggest ones was "You Deserve a Break Today" for McDonald's. But yeah, he's responsible for the Oscar Mayer stuff. It's hard to miss John Travolta, young or old. You know, he has that look. I think it's the eyes. Remember The Boy in the Bubble? Remember that movie? Back to our originally scheduled program, already in progress.
Love, exciting and new. Come aboard, we're expecting you. Love, life's sweetest reward. Adventure your mind on a new romance and love won't hurt anymore. It's an open sore, open smile on a friendly shore.
Also a great show. I love how they rotated lots and lots of guest stars. It, you know, that's what kept people coming back to this show, I think. And also helped enormously to give a renaissance, or I would say a renaissance, to the cruising industry, because before that, cruising was just a means of getting from one point to another. And then Princess, which was the brand they used in the show, kind of opened the way for what is now modern cruising, where you can stay on the ship and be entertained and have a vacation all in itself. A couple more to go before our broadcast day is finished. Yeah, we gotta have this cheesy 70s song sound on this song. I'm really tongue-tied today, I'm sorry. I think it's because I'm really excited about this show. You'll recognize this right away too.
Come and knock on our door. We've been waiting for you. We've been kissing down hers and hers and his. Please come and do. Come and dance on the floor. Take a step that is new. A lovable space that needs your face. Please come and do. You'll see that life is a falling and laughter is calling for you.
at our rendezvous. Three's company, two.
John Ritter, who was the name of the brunette of the trio? Janet somebody, or was Janet her character name? Anyway, that song was written by Joe Raposo, who wrote a lot of stuff. Of note to me is he wrote Bean Green for Kermit the Frog. So you never know where writers are going to have their hand. This one is such a request from my friend Laura. Somebody said earlier, hearing these songs makes you want to see the shows. I agree with that. I'm going to have to dig up some of these.
Welcome back. Your dreams are your ticket out. Welcome back to that same old place that you laughed about. That you hung around, but those dreams have remained and they've turned around. Who would have thought to lead you back here when we need you? Now we're teasing it up because we got a little spot. Welcome back, welcome back, welcome back, welcome back, welcome back, welcome back, welcome back.
I used to watch, I have very faint memories of that show, but I do remember seeing some of the reruns. And well, that brings us back to John Travolta, doesn't it? Mr. Carter. Well, it's time. I wore the garb, so it's time to sing this song now.
Sit right back and you hear it tell a tale of a fateful trip. Started from this tropic port aboard this tiny ship. The mate was a mighty sailing man and the skipper a brave and sure. Five passengers had sailed that never 3 hour tour, a 3 hour tour. The weather started getting rough and the tiny ship was tossed. If not for the courage of the fearless crew, the middle would be lost. The middle would be lost. The ship sank ground on the shore of this uncharted desert isle. I would kill again the skipper too, the millionaire and his wife, the professor and the movie star, Candy Pearl, Professor and Mary Ann.
Hey, if my brother Bill is watching still, remember the Pulusi Bagumba episode where they were taken prisoner by the savages? Pulusi Bagumba was a phrase to release the prisoners. Oh, the shit we remember. Okay, let's do this.
Here's a story of a lovely lady who was bringing up three very lovely girls. All of them had hair of gold, like their mother, the youngest one in curls. Here's the story of a man named Brady, who was busy with three boys of his own. There were four men living all together, yet they were all alone. Till one day when this lady met this fellow, and they knew that it was much more than a hunch, group would somehow form a family.
it all became the Brady Bunch, the Brady Bunch, the Brady Bunch. That's the way we became the Brady Bunch.
Alice!
Wah, 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 wah. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba.
Great show. You know, it's that clean, wholesome television programming from that time. This one goes out to Yvonne.
So no one told you life was gonna be this way. Your job's a joke, you broke, your love last year away. It's like you're always stuck in second gear. Well, it hasn't been your day, your week, your month, or even your year. Still in bed at 10 and work again at 8. You've burned your breakfast so far, things are going great. Your mother warned you there'd be days like these, but she didn't tell you what the world had you on your knees. I'll be there for you when the rain starts to pour. I've been there before, I'll be there for you, 'cause you're there for me too.
Yeah, of course, that's Friends. Not a show that I watched a lot of, honestly. I know it was enormously successful. And at the end, they were making $1 million apiece each episode. Wow. A couple more, and then I'm going to bid you adieu, my friends. The time goes fast for me, anyway. I'm having a great time with you. I need to change the voicing on the piano. Is it this one? Yeah. Before I lose track at the end here, I just want to thank you again for dropping in this week and every week, or whenever you can. Thanks for all your generosity in the tip bowl. Believe me, it's helping a great deal through this tough time when I'm unemployed. So thank you for keeping me working. I mean that from the bottom of my heart. I appreciate it very much. Still no word from Morgan's when we're going to be reopening, but we're all crossing our fingers that we'll be back there sometime in the fall. My best guess, and this is speculation, would be, I don't know, maybe October. We'll see. But when we do open, I hope you'll make your way out to Palm Springs and see me. And as usual, I'll always blast out on social media any new news. Going back now a little bit on this one.
Who can turn the world on with a smile? Who can take a nothing day and suddenly make it seem worthwhile? It's you, girl, and you should know it. With each glance and every movement you show it, love's all around, no need to waste it. You can have the town, no need to take it. You're gonna make it after all. Most likely to succeed. You have the looks and charms, and girl, you know that's all you need. All the men around adore you. That sexy look will do wonders for you. Love is all around, no need to waste it. You can have the town, no need to take it. You're gonna make it after.
Come to the end of my song list. I want to thank you again, everybody. And I didn't want to discuss it in the middle of the show, but some of you who know Nancy Real, who is my partner in crime in planning and executing our Rentourage cruises, and my dear friend, her husband Joe passed away last night. I'm afraid to have to share with you. He'd been ailing for a little bit of time, but the Lord called him up a little sooner than we would all want. So please keep Nancy and Joey, her son, and other family and friends in your prayers. I'm sure she would, you know, not want to be bothered right away with a bombardment of messages. So as her friend, I would ask you to give her a little space. But Joe was a great man, a retired veterinarian. They lived down in Puerto Vallarta. Just reaching out to them with all my heart. And again, I won't be here next week. I'll be hopefully wading in the water of the Pacific Ocean for a couple of days. Looking forward to that after months of this BS. But I'll see you in 2 weeks' time, I hope, right back here. Same Ron time, same Ron channel.
I'm so glad we had this time together, just to have a laugh or sing a song. Since we just get started and before we know it, comes a time we have to say so long. There's a time you put aside for dreaming, and a time for things you have to do. But the time I like the best is any Sunday evening. I can spend a moment here with you. When the time comes and I'm feeling lonely, and that feeling is oh so blue, I just sit back and I think of you only, and then the happiness will come shining through. That's why I'm glad we had this time together, 'cause it makes me feel that I belong. Since we just get started and before you know it, comes a time we have to say so long.
Kelly Burnett, my friends. Oh. This concludes our broadcast day. I'll see you soon. I love you guys. Thank you.